The scenes out here help duplicate extreme wear seen on trucks or vehicles that Nissan tests. It accelerates the wear to try and duplicate 10, 15, maybe even 20 years, depending on how much mileage we put on the vehicles out in this area. We check out here for squeak and rattle noises, also durability of all the components of the vehicle from suspension to seats and also tire wear. In testing in our durability course, it's crucial to use human drivers as feedback. They can feel other things that the robot might not be able to compute or dictate to the engineer, such as, you know, when I was going over this seat, I felt a squeak or something like that. So we can get that real life feedback from the driver and feed that back to design and try and make an improvement if needed.
We're actually looking at the new next generation Titan. It's being prepped right now for four-post durability, which is a long-term test to confirm market usage up to 20 years in the vehicle-grade market. We basically run through a number of roads. There's about four or five different roads that we input into the vehicle. They're all pretty severe. One of the most unique ones is the twist load that we put in the vehicle. Other road types include what we call a splash rough or a Belgian block, and also a fixed stone. All of these are the most severe roads that you would typically find in a marketplace. These roads that we're putting into the four-post shaker are exactly the same as the roads in Arizona. Basically, we're taking the data from Arizona and inputting them into the four-post chamber and using that to simulate the vehicle. The window of time for testing actually really depends on each vehicle, but for the next generation Titan, it's expected to be in here for between 1 to 2 months actually for testing. And that would represent about 600,000 kilometers of actual market usage, or about 370,000 miles in market usage.
Right now we're running the hood durability test. We look for the aging characteristics of the hood under repetitive open-close operation. We're doing the door open-close durability, and there as well, similar as the hood, we look for the aging characteristics under repetitive open close. We run thousands of cycles to represent more than 15 years in service.
When we're considering a pickup truck, when we do our testing, we're gonna look at things like approach angles when we for off-road usage, and then just for overall industrial use, because there's gonna be more things that can contact the vehicle. So compared to a passenger vehicle that typically stays on road, the severity is going to be a little bit higher. One of the tests that we do is what we call a flooded road test, and that's simply just to see how the vehicle performs driving through a flooded road situation, whether this be on road or off road. We want to make sure that the integrity of the vehicle is maintained and that there's not going to be any significant concerns after driving through something like this. So when we do what we call the road interference tests, we're looking at the what parts of the vehicle can contact given something like a curb stone or something like a drainage ditch or a sidewalk separator, any kind of road interference that the customer may encounter.
Sometimes it may seem like just the little things that we do aren't really important, but down the line in 10 years when this truck's 10 years old, and there's still no rattles inside the car, I can feel good about that.
I'm proud about every vehicle I'm involved with, in particular the truck, just because of my truck history with helping out soldiers and giving them a safe vehicle. I want that same feeling with everyone that gets to drive this truck.